Hello, everyone. If you're from Chicago, then you are familiar with the Blackhawks. So this video is for all my fans out there. So let's get to it. To do so, you first need to bake a cake in a 9-inch round pan, and I used the vanilla cake recipe. I had baked in 4 9-inch round pans, but that really depends on how much batter you use. I just used that many to get the height of the cake that I wanted. Once the cakes are cooled completely, level the cakes so they have a flat surface. Place one round cake on top of the cake board and start frosting the top. I used vanilla buttercream frosting that was dyed yellow. You can obviously use any cake recipe or frosting you wish. So frost the first cake and then place the other round cake on top and repeat if you have more cake. And then frost the whole cake. You can crumb coat the cake if you wish, however, because I'm putting fondant on top, I am not. So since I mentioned putting fondant on top, let's get to that step. I am trying to make this look like a hockey puck, so I will be using black fondant. So take black fondant and roll it out on a prepared surface. Once it is rolled to about a 1/4 inch, take your cake and gently place the black fondant covering the whole cake. Start smoothing the fondant, and I like to start on the top first and then slowly work my way to the side. Once it is covered, trim off unnecessary fondant. Now I'll show you how to make the logo. I printed the logo from the internet and it's really easy to find it. I then cut the logo and trace it on another paper so it would be slightly larger than the original image I printed. So you'll be needing different colors of fondant for this logo. So I first rolled out white fondant to about a 1/4 inch thickness and cut the slightly larger picture. Then I did the same with black fondant. Roll it out to a 1/4 inch and cut around the original image you printed. And you'll be putting that on top of the white fondant. Now for the rest of the logo, I cut the feathers and then the face from the picture. So first roll out the light brown fondant and take the image of just the face from the logo and cut around that. Then take the colors red, green, yellow, and orange and cut the feathers and cut whatever else has to be cut, like the little circles above the feathers and then the two little squares above the feathers. Once you cut all those out, brush water on the back of each feather or the face and then place these where they belong on the black fondant. For the details on the face, I took a black edible marker, or you can use black frosting, and draw or pipe the details on the face. Also with red edible marker or frosting, and then white, pipe the details on the face. Same with the rest of the logo. The feathers all have details on them and they all have different colors. So use the picture as your guide. I placed the frosting Ziploc bag and snipped the corner and used that to pipe the details. Once you have all the details piped, your logo is ready to be placed on top of the cake. Brush water on the back and place it on the center of the cake. You can either leave the cake like that, but what I did was I took white fondant and with my letter fondant cutters, roll happy birthday and place it on top of the cake. You can write the person's name at the bottom if this is for a birthday. Or you can write Chicago Blackhawks or write whatever you want. And that's it. This is how I made a Chicago Blackhawks cake. If you're a Blackhawks fan, comment down below and let me know. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video.